Ma'am, you're giving an option for the students to choose a religion. Now, wouldn't it somehow affect some of the children's sensibilities in the class? Because finally, we are talking about religion here.
The theme is religion, but it can be not a particular religion. It's a diversity of religions. That is what we have to prepare them for all
kinds of respect. I'm still not here. Let's say I'm a Hindu guy and I have a Christian friend. There are certain things in Christianity that I like. But in no manner I can say that I am bigger than him or he is bigger than me. I think the debate somewhere, I mean in the classroom if a debate is on, somewhere if a debate switches up, it might just go on to becoming, you know, my religion is bigger than yours. So in
how do you take
war,
care of
my major better thing is that how will you take care of such a situation?
The instructions are given not to be very sensitive about the religious aspects. But projecting all the religions, the common love, to have a common culture, it's not a common culture, to have a faith and respect to each other's cultures.
The teacher has to maintain the decorum in the classroom.
So how will you bring out, I mean, can I have a few examples of how you are you bringing out the better things of one religion? Let's say we'll talk about whichever you want first.
Now, if you think, say the common, God is one. Everyone, every religion says that God is one. So common aspects of the simplicity, honesty, true, being respectful. All these are taught in every religion. So those aspects can be taken, though the different religions are being projected. You have the same common.
Ma'am, one more question.
We do not go into details and
here. Thank you. One more question. You have time for one more
question.
The third question is also, I'm still not clear about the idea because this is one thing that I seriously don't understand. As a Hindu boy, I have been beating all these follow like several gods. Like there's Durga Puja and then soon there is Saraswati Puja and then there's Kali Puja. So I was always confused between which god to follow. That way I find Christianity better. There's only one person to look after. There's only one person to appease.
It's not a question of how many gods you worship. It's only the faith.
So,
you don't have to worship any god.
And she made the statement that there's one god. I had two objections, one of which you already pointed. The other objection is there are a lot of, I mean, in India after Christianity, Islam and Hinduism, the fourth largest set of beliefs is of agnostics and atheists. However, those students
you don't have to be a religious person.
Probably, I think a better way of doing it is to maybe tell the student that this is a question which has a lot of answers. I have chosen this particular answer for myself.
An innovative solution.